Say, guys, let me tell you how my day went. Hot again, dealing with the police. I'm packing up my things, sorting things out. Just took out my makeshift tent. And I go sitting on the grass, sorting everything out, and the police tell me I have to leave. But I took my time, because they see me already packing. To say that you're littering. Of course, if you take your things out the tent, it's going to be on the grass until you pack it up. Well, we'd appreciate it if you go right now. But I didn't. But I went to see Miss Metal. And again, the game playing at the parole office. The receptionist told me she was not there. I told her I'd wait because I had to charge my device anyway. She asked me if I didn't want to speak to her officer today. And I said, no, I'll wait till Miss Metal gets here. So I waited an hour and a half. Miss Metal still in came. So I said, can I speak to your officer today? Because I want to get out of there. She tells me that Miss Metal's at the officer today, and she's not there. Now, earlier she told me that I want to speak to your officer today, Miss Metal's not there. So I told her, say, well, I'm not going to sit here all day because since she's officer today and she's not here, she might not never show up. Well, some days I've been there, she hasn't been there all day. So, at almost 2 o'clock, she shows up. And I had been there since 11:45. She shows up almost 2 o'clock. I asked her, I said, since I'm having all this police harassment, who do I go to talk to about police misconduct? Because, number one, I asked her about the discrimination laws. Because the police are supposed to stand up for you against discrimination. At least give you a police report so you can take it and say, well, these people say she did not come in yet. So, in Chicago and in other places, they have, like, the Office of Professional Standards that you can go to about police misconduct, or they have Internal Affairs in Chicago where you can go to about police misconduct. I deal with all of them. They have never taken complaints against officers against me. One DSO in Chicago paid complaint when an officer took a $100 bill out of my wallet at their daily courthouse downtown Chicago. $100 came missing from my wallet. So when I asked for investigation, because you know we have cameras everywhere, especially in these courthouses and these, you know, government buildings. So when I asked them to go look at the cameras, they said they don't have cameras. Come on now. We know all these courthouses, all these government buildings have cameras. But the investigation never went through. So Ms. Little tell me that I have to go to a sergeant. No, what she say first is, go see a lawyer. You have to hire a lawyer. But these cases of discrimination. But that has nothing to do with police misconduct. Because the police are supposed to know the law of what discrimination is, since all these businesses are barring me out. So, I'm going to take advice. I'm going to try to find, because you know, all cities have those legally lawyers that's supposed to help you for free. They're supposed to take on cases. So, I'm going tomorrow or maybe the next day and find me a legally lawyer. Now, let me show you one other thing. And I'll talk about this cricket service later. But let me zoom out. While I was charging on my phone, we're not sure I was just phoning the dead pro office. But Park Evers leave, it would not come on. And as you see, the battery completed. How did that happen? It's on a charge, this little phone, this toy phone, for 2 hours, and then it went, come on. But when I got here to the park, I opened it up, and it came on, but it has no power. So it's going to go out in about 1 or 2 minutes. So, as I say, they hacked my devices at the parole office. They messed with my power of charging. And as I said, I'm surprised it came on when I got here. But it's dead. Has no battery power after being on the phone, on the charger for 2 hours. All right, guys. Well, it was a little more than 2 hours, from 11:45 to 2 o'clock. So, I'm going to unblow this. And my phone here that I got in my hand, when I left Ms. Monroe's office and got here to the park, it had 82% charge. Now it's down to, like, 34. And this is the only video. It hasn't loaded up. I just made it. And I'm, you know, I'm recording it. And it's already down to 34, 33. All right, guys. Try to load this.